Hi, this is Munson with Munson Music, and we're talking about how you could play a song called Big Yellow Taxi. And we're going to end up moving this with the capo actually to 2nd fret, but we're going to start out on a G major chord for our intro. And then we play G major. First finger is going to go to the A string on the 2nd fret. Second finger is going to go to the low E string on the 3rd fret. And the 3rd finger is going to go to the high E string on the 3rd fret. And if you strum all those together, that sounds a G major chord, and it sounds really, really happy. And on the intro, I actually kind of work it off of the team. From the G, we're going to go to an A major chord. We play A major. First finger is going to go to the D string on the 2nd fret. Second finger is going to go to the G string on the 2nd fret. And third finger is going to go to the B string on the 2nd fret. So it's a big party on the 2nd fret. And if you strum all those together, that sounds A major. It sounds really, really happy. And then from the A major, we're going to be going to a D major chord. And we play D major. First finger is going to go to the G string on the 2nd fret. Second finger is going to go to the high E on the 2nd fret. And the third finger is going to go to the B string on the 3rd fret. And if you kind of strum just the D, G, B, and E, then that sounds a D major chord. That sounds really, really happy. And that's kind of our intro, actually. It's kind of that G major, A major, D major, D major, D major, D major. And there are a couple different strum patterns actually we'll talk about, and actually some licks actually kind of working some suspended chords kind of around those to really match the recording. We're going to start out with just a really simple way of playing kind of our song, working off a 4-4 strum pattern. One of my favorite ones, down, down, up, up, down, up. So we took the G and just tried that a lot. You have down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up, down, up. So we tried that through our intro progression. We have G with a down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up. Mixing up a lot of what we just talked about. So we tried our verse with our strum pattern. We have G with a down, down, up, up, down, 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 G down, down, up, up, down, A down, down, up, up, down, G with a down, down, up, down, G with a down, down, up, down, up. And then from there we'd be going into our chorus part. Our chorus mixes up some things, and we actually end up halving some chords. So one way to kind of easily play through the chorus, with our strum pattern, we have D with a down, down, up, up, down, D, down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, D, down, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, A, down, down, up, up, down, D, 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 down, down, up, up, down, up. Now the weird thing is, though, to play along with the recording, actually, the Amy Grant and the Joni versions, what you want to do is kind of take a capo, because instead of starting on a D, they're starting on an E major chord. And if you put the capo on 2nd fret, then now your D major is really an E major, your G major is really an A major, and your A major is really a B major chord. So to take it from the very, very beginning, we kind of work through our intro part with our down, down, up, up, down, up. We'd have G with a down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up. So we have G with a down, down, up, up, down, G with a down, down, up, up, down, G with a down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, A, down, down, up, up, down, D, down, down, up, up, down, D, down, down, up, up, down, up. And then we'd be on our chorus part. So we got our D with a down, down, up. Down, down, G with a down, down, G with a down, down, G down, down, up, up, down, A down, down, up, down, G with 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 a down, down, up, down, up. Now through this song, though, there's some really cool hits actually around some other D's and other A chords. And while you're on the D major, actually, if you kind of take the pinky and kind of put him on the high E string on the 3rd fret. So now I got first finger on the G string, 2nd, 3rd finger on the B string, 3rd, and the pinky on the high E string, 3rd. That's what we call D sus. And what can sound really cool is to kind of switch between the D and the D sus through the tune. And we can even do that with the down, down, up, up, down. Down, 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 up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. So it's almost like having a little D lick. And then on the A major, actually, you kind of get that same idea by adding in something called A sus. And if you kind of take the A major that we're on, we got first finger on the D on the second, second finger on the G second, third finger on the B string second. If you take the pinky and kind of add them in on the B string on the third, that's called an A sus. So you can really kind of get the same kind of sounds by adding in the pinky around the A major. So those can kind of become like D licks and A licks for when you're on those chords. So we kind of tried that through our intro. We could have the G with a down, down, up, up, down, G with a down, down. G with a down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, D, down, down, up, up, down, D, down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, D, down, down, up, up, down, D, down, down, up, up, down, D, down, down, up, up, down, up. Actually, I kind of jumped into a different voicing for G there, too, that you may want to play around with. It's really close to the D sus, where you do first finger on the A string, second fret. Second finger on the low E string on the third, third finger on the B string on the third, just like the D sus, and then the pinky on the high E string on the third fret, kind of just like the D sus. So that's another voicing for G, so it's a little bit easier to kind of get from the D major or the D sus to that G. You may want to kind of think about using that as kind of a substitute for the G. So we tried that playing around with our chorus. We could just do the down, down when we get to that G, D halving. And then we have D with the down, down, up, down, D, down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up. Down, G, down, down, D, down, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, A, down, down, up, up, down, D, 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 down, down, up, up, down, up. Now, if you wanted to, too, something else that I like adding to a song like this is bass notes. And a lot of times on the very first down of the down, down, up, up, down, you can kind of play a bass for the chord. So for instance, on the G chord, you have the low E string for your bass. So low E bass, down, up, up, down, G to the low E bass, down, up, up, down, G to the low E bass, down, up, up, down. On the A chord, you have the A string for your bass. G with an A bass, down, up, up, down, G with an A bass, down, up, up, down, G with an A bass, down, up, up, down. And on the D, you have the D string for your bass. So D bass, down, up, up, down, G to the D bass, down. Tried our intro with our basses. We have G with the low E bass down, up, up, down, G with low E bass down, up, up, down, A with an A bass down, up, up, down, B with an A bass down, up, up, down, G with a D bass down, up, up, down, B with a D bass down, up, up, down, B with a D bass down, up, up, down, B with a D bass down, up, up, down, up. And then we tried our verse with that. We'd have the G with the low E bass down, up, down, G with the low E bass down, up, up, down, G with a D bass down. We'd have D with the D bass down, up, up, down, D with the D bass down, up, up, down, G with low E bass down, up, up, down. When you have them, you can do just kind of a bass down up on the G, bass down up on the D. And then we have the G with the low E bass down, up, down, A with an A bass down, up, down, D with the D bass down, up. Think about it on the halving part. We got the G and D. Another way to half that would be doing the G with the down, down, and then hitting the D on the up, up, down. So we tried our chorus that way. You'd have D with the D, down, up, up, down, D with the down, down, up, up, down, G, down, down, up, up, down, G with the down, down, D on the up, up, down, G with the down, down, up, down, D with the down, down, up, down, D with the down, down, up, down, D with the down, down, up, down. Think about that. Another way to do it with the bass is we do kind of the G with a bass down and then hit the D on the up, up, down. So we're going to try it with kind of that idea for our bass note. We'd have D with a D bass down, up, up, down, D with a D bass down, up, up, down, G with a low E bass down, up, up, song. Now, in the recording, actually, at least the Joni Mitchell version, actually, there's a really cool 16th note strum pattern that you could play around with, too. And what I mean by that is right now, if you're tapping your foot to the beat, our down, down, up, 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 down, up is kind of dividing that beat into two parts. One, two, one, two. That's called an eighth note. What a 16th note is where you divide that into four parts. So one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. And what I think could be really cool to kind of play around with the recording is down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, up. And what I mean by that is if you take the G and do a down, up, down, up, kind of for the one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, down, up, down. That's what you'd be doing on the first beat. And on the second beat, if you do a down on one, down on three, up on four, you have one, two, three, four, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up. And then on the third beat, you're going to up on two, down on three. So you have one, two, three, four, one, up, down, one, up, down, one, up, down, one, up, down. And then on the fourth beat, you're going down, up, down, right along with the one, two, three, four. So you have down, up, down, up, down, up, down, just like the first beat. So all together, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, up. This could be kind of a cool pattern to work. If we try that through our intro, the weird thing is now you feel like you've only got kind of one time through for each, or one chord going on where we did have two before. So we try that through the intro, you'd have G with a down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, A, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, B, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, 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 up, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. And you can kind of throw in those sus licks, and a lot of what I'm doing actually there for that D lick is kind of that down on the sus, up on the D. Down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, up, down, up. Yeah, so you may want to kind of play around with that. That might be kind of cool. And if we tried that through our verse part, the weird part is now our G and A kind of feel like they're halving. So on that part, you could do the G with the down, up, down, up, down, down, and hit the A for the up, up, down, down, up, down. So we got G down, up, down, up, down, down, A on the up, up, down, A down, up, down, up. Kind of where we're halving. So we tried our verse that way. We'd have G with a down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, G, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, G, down, up, down, up, down, down, A, up, up, down, down, up, down, G with a down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. And if we kind of tried that idea through our chorus part, we'd end up, we kind of do the whole pattern on the D. But the weird part is on the G, you'd have the down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up. And then D with the down, up, down, up. That's kind of how we'd end up halving that. And then we kind of have our G and A kind of halving again, where we'd have the G with the down, up, down, up, down, down, A on the up, up, down, down, up, down, up. And then back to the D for the whole strum pattern. Down, up, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. So through our verse, or through our chorus, we'd have D with the down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, G, down, up, down, up, down, down, up, up, D, down. Kind of throw your basses in with that too. Now the weird part about that is you don't have a whole lot of time. You can kind of do a bass up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, G, bass up, down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down, up. So we tried that through our intro. We'd have G with a bass up, down, up, down, down, up. G with a bass up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, G with a bass up, down, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up. chorus, then we have D with the bass up, down, up, down, down, up. G bass up down up down down on the up up bass down up down do the bass up down up down down up down down up down do bass up down up down up down down up down up. So just to review that one more time on the verse, you got G with the bass up down up down down up up bass down up down up. So now I'm going to throw in those extra basses. So I'm going bass up down up down down up up bass down up down up. And then you got the D with the bass up down up down. We got the D with the bass up, down, up, down, up, up, bass, down, up, down, G, the bass up, down, up, down, down, up, up, bass, D, down, up, down, G, bass up, down, up, down, 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 up, up, bass, down, up, down, do the bass up, down, up, down, down, up. So you want to kind of play around with those ideas too. But that's the basics of how you could strum through Big Yellow Taxi by Joni Mitchell, or the Amy Grant version, actually. It's kind of in the same key. So good luck!